Hello. Here we'll discuss briefly few exercises that will help you in consolidating the concepts you learned so far. So let's get started. First, two seven exercises basically assumes the following scenario, that is, a server is sending a 10 megabyte file. Please understand, 1 byte is 18 bits. So that means 10 megabyte file would mean 80 megabits. Understand that part, because I have seen most of the time people making a mistake and assuming byte as the same bit. Then they will have a client and a server connected. There could be one link or two link or multiple links, but unless specified otherwise, each link in the path is 10 Mbps link. Remember, it is bits, 10 megabits per second and not bytes. For all our exercises, we'll assume that speed of communication, electromagnetic waves in copper medium, the links is 2 into 10 is to power 5 kilometers per second, that is 2 lakh kilometers per second, which is basically the speed of electromagnetic waves in copper medium. And let's assume for the moment that the server is at a physical distance of 10,000 kilometers from the client. That is all the link length with whatever they are bending something, the total link length, including intermediate links together from client to the server, is 10,000 kilometers. Based on this, request you to do the following exercises and find the answer. First one is, suppose that client and server, my client and server, only one link, which is, we are saying, 10,000 kilometer. 10,000 kilometer, this is the link, and whole file is sent as a single packet. Then what would be the transmission delay? We are asking only transmission delay. Remember, there are four kind of delays we studied: transmission delay, propagation delay, queuing delay, and processing delay. So when on a one link between client and server to send the entire 10 megabyte file, which is 80 megabits, what would be the transmission delay? Pause the video, work out your answer, and then verify. Assuming worked out, remember it is 80 megabits file. My transmission rate is, as we already said, the 10 megabits per second. This is what we assumed. If you look at the previous case, we already said all our links are 10 megabits per second. So transmitting 80 megabits on a 10 Mbps link will take us 8 seconds. So A is the correct answer. Let's go to the next question. Suppose that there is only one link, but now we are still sending the 10 megabyte file as a single packet, but we'd like to know what is the time taken by client to receive the entire file. That is, we are trying to look at end-to-end delay. Remember, there is only one link in this case. So I have a client connected to a server. There is only one link, so there is no queuing there. We can ignore the processing delay. So on this, there will be no queuing, so no queuing delay, no processing delay. So what is end-to-end delay when this file is sent from client to the server on a single link? Pause the video, work out your calculations, and then give us the answer. So if we look, the transmission delay would be 8 seconds, and my propagation delay is 10,000 kilometer divided by 2 into 10 raised to power kilometer per second, and this will basically give me 0.05 second. Transmission delay is, so let's say I would say my TD is equal to 8 second, my TP propagation delay is 0.05 second. So my total delay would be 8 plus 0.5, which is 8.05. So B would be the right answer. Let's go to next question. Next question is, what is the bandwidth delay product in this case? That is, when a server starts transmitting, and which is really applicable when it starts transmitting and first bit, so this is my server client, and server client starts sending to the data to server. When it starts sending first bit starts going, and by the time first bit reaches, client may still be transmitting. So what are the number of these bits in the network medium, the link? That means, what is the number of bits which are in this link by the time first bit reaches the server and client is still transmitting? Pause the video, work out your details, and then give us the answer. As you figure out the answer, you look at my transmission delay. So how much time a bit would take from go from here to here? The time taken is propagation delay, which is 0.05 second. Now my transmission rate is 10 megabits. So per second, I'm transmitting 10 into 10 raised to power 6 bit per second. So in 1 second, I'm transmitting this much. How much time I'll take, how many bits I'll transmit in 0.05 second, that will fill my the entire medium. So when I multiply 0.05 in by 10 into 10 to power 6, your answer would be 5 lakh bits. So C is the correct answer. Question number 4. Let's assume that client and server are connected by two links. So let's say we have a client, then I have intermediate router, and then I have another link which is server. So two link, and each link is 5000 kilometers. Total distance is still, if you look at, 10,000 kilometer, and client still sends the entire 10 megabyte file as one packet. So compute the end-to-end delay, assuming there is router has no other packet to transmit. That means there is no queuing at the router, and we can assume processing delay to be zero. So compute end-to-end delay when client sends entire 1 megabyte to the server. Remember, packet has to come. Only router will start transmitting only when it receives the entire packet, then it transmits. So work out your answers. Pause the video. Assume you worked out. Look. This transmission rate is 10 Mbps. So client to the server, it will take me 8 seconds. A router will start transmitting only receives the entire packet. This again link is 10 Mbps. A router will take another 8 seconds because 80 megabits by 10 Mbps. So this is purely 8 plus 8. 16 is purely transmission delay, but I still need to have propagation delay. A bit would take from here to here and here to here. That time still time is, propagation delay is 0.05, transmission delay is 16 second, propagation delay is 0.05. so my total delay is 16.05, and hence B would be the correct answer. Let's look at the same question, but assume that now we have two links. That means client, I have a router, and then I have a server. Each link again is 5000 kilometers. But this time we'll assume that the client, rather than sending a single 10 megabyte file, it makes 5 packets. That means each packet is 2 megabyte each. So it sent 5 such packet, 2 megabyte each. Then what is the time taken end-to-end delay, assuming router has no other packets in the network, so there is no queuing delay. Any queuing has to happen, this packet to receive. So compute the end-to-end delay. That is when client starts sending first bit of the first packet till the last bit of the last packet received by the server. Pause the video, work out your answer, and then you resume. Assume you have worked out. So if you look at, now first packet is 2 megabytes. 2 megabyte is 16 megabits. 16 megabits at the rate of 10 Mbps, it will take me 1.6 seconds. Now when router receives first packet of 2 megabit, when receives the full packet, it can start transmitting the first packet and client can start transmitting second packet. When router receives second packet and when it transmits second packet, client can start transmitting third packet and so on and so forth. When client will send packet number 5, router would be sending packet number 4. And that means if you look at the, when router sends all the packet, client has only one packet extra overhead, because the last packet, when router is sending the last packet, client is not sending anything. So router sends all packet plus one packet delay of the first packet of the client. So total transmission delay would be 1.6 into 5, which is this, plus one packet delay here. So I'll get 8 seconds plus 1.6 seconds, which gives me 9.6 seconds is my transmission delay. My propagation delay still remains 0.05 seconds. So my total time would be 9.65 seconds. And so answer would be D in this case. Let's look at the next question. Assuming that now client is connected to the server by 5 links. There are 4 routers. So I have a client, I have a router 1, router 2, router 3, router 4, and then I have the server. So I have 5 links, each of this, and then again file is broken down into 5 equal size packet. How much the end-to-end delay, assuming there is no congestion in the network, how much time it will take. Pause the video, work out your answers, and then we'll see. So assuming you worked out, follow the same logic. First packet and client sends, no other activity. When first packet goes, when client sends, when first packet received, router start transmitting first packet and client can transmit it second packet. When router 2 start transmitting first packet, router R1 will transmit second packet and client can start transmitting third packet. When this is received, when R3 start transmitting first packet, R2 would be transmitting second packet, R1 would be transmitting third packet, and C1 would be transmitting fourth packet. And similarly, when R4 start transmitting first packet, R2 will be transmitting second packet, R2 will start transmitting third packet, R1 will start transmitting fourth packet, and client will transmitting fifth packet. So if you look at, when the client sends all the 5 packets, nothing has reached, there are still 4 packets in the pipeline. So total delay would be, if you look at 5 packets which I'll be sending, which will take me 8 seconds, and then I have four more packets that will go on in the pipeline because of the four links, and that will take 1.6 into 4, which is 6.4. So 8 plus 6.4, this will give me 8 plus 6.4 would give me 14.4 seconds. This for transmission delay, and I have a propagation delay of 0.05. This is my propagation delay because total distance is still 10,000 kilometers. So my total time taken would be 14.45 seconds. That would be the answer. Same way, you work out the question number 7. Assume there are four links, but this time link lengths are different. The first link, so let's say C, I have a R1, R2, R3, and then the server. So this link is 1000 kilometer. Second link is 2000 kilometer. Third link is 3000 kilometer, and fourth link is 4000 kilometer. Further, the way packets are distributed, they are still same. We still send 5 equal size packets, that each packet is 2 megabytes. But let's look at my transmission rate are different. Transmission rate between client to R1 is 2 Mbps. From R1 to R2, it is 4 Mbps. From R2 to R3, it is 8 Mbps. And for R3 to server, it is 10 Mbps. So please understand now, transmission delay on this first link would be different. This would be different. This would be different. And this would be different depending on the speed. I would have the very high transmission delay, 2 Mbps link, and I have 2 megabyte packets. So this will take 8 seconds for the first packet. On this link, same packet, it will take 4 seconds, it will take 2 seconds, and so on, so forth. So you look at and then compute and work out your total answers. So end-to-end delay would probably come to a 47.65. Work it out and we deal with it. Next question is different. So consider that we have 10 connections traverse the same link of rate of 2 Gbps. So let's say we have a number of clients, client 1 to client n, and each client is connected on the link of 5 Mbps, and they share a common link, and this common link is 2 Gbps. And let's say there are 10 clients now. So C1, all the 10 clients are using this link. Each client is sending at the rate of what we say is 5 Mbps. Then what is the maximum throughput for each connection? Pause the video, work out the answer. Assume you worked out, you look at, even if all the 10 people send, total data dumped into this would be 50 Mbps. That means there is no choking on this network. That means each connection will get the full throughput of 5. So answer would be 5 Mbps. So essentially what we had done, we defined some exercises that will help you understand how does my delay work, end-to-end delay work. And we'll have another exercise to understand, review what we studied there. Thank you.